Students often find prioritization questions frustrating because they may offer more than one right answer. These types of questions reveal one of the most difficult realities for nursing students, and that is that the right answer may be incorrect because it's not the best answer. But don't let this discourage you. The tough reality is that well-constructed exam questions, even the ones perceived as tricky, can actually train your brain to be more attentive to detail. And this is an essential skill that you will use on a daily basis as a nurse. Hi, I'm Anna, and I'm a critical care registered nurse who has a lot of experience taking care of really sick kids. I also pass the NCLEX quickly and with the minimum amount of questions. So let's talk about some test-taking strategies that this video will go over. As always, timestamps are provided for you in the description so you can jump around easily. First, we are going to talk about what prioritization questions are really asking. We will then talk about some ways that you can quickly recognize these types of questions. Finally, we will then go over stable versus unstable patients and why determining stability is the key to answering prioritization questions. In testing questions and in real life, you will need to be able to identify prioritization questions immediately. Usually, this will come down to determining who is the most or the least stable. And this is what prioritization questions are really wanting you to think about. How stable or unstable is your patient? Now, I'm sure you are all familiar with using tools like the ABCs, airway, breathing, and circulation, and Maslow's hierarchy of needs to help determine stability and therefore prioritization. And that can be helpful in questions like this. We can look at this answer set and pretty quickly determine that respiratory status is the patient's highest need because we first and foremost want to see if our patients are breathing. However, rarely are nursing school or NCLEX questions this straightforward. Most of us know to prioritize breathing above circulation and our ABCs, but what happens when all of your answers pertain to the patient's airway and you have to determine which airway answer represents the highest priority? This is where exploring the concept of stability can be helpful. There are multiple keywords and phrases that can clue you into questions where you will need to determine the patient's stability. Like, what patient could be assigned to a new graduate nurse? Which patient could be assigned to a float nurse? To help you determine who is the most stable, be on the lookout for keywords like history of, normal lab results, post-op greater than 12 hours. When you are analyzing these questions, remember that signs and symptoms that pertain to the patient's condition or disease process aren't necessarily bad. It is helpful to ask yourself, is my patient experiencing what I would expect them to given their current disease process or condition? If the answer is no, then your patient may be unstable. Patients with changing conditions are unstable. Unstable keywords and phrases include recently admitted, changing condition, acute, and post-op less than 12 hours, to name a few. In the next video, we are going to go over a few practice questions together and start applying these tools. But a great place to start is to go through each answer provided and ask questions like these. Is the patient experiencing what I would expect them to experience based on their disease or condition? Is this an urgent need that needs to happen at this very moment? Is the patient's condition changing? Using these types of questions and tools will help you rank your patient's stability in your answer set. You will then be able to determine who to assess first, which patient could be assigned to a float nurse, and any other type of scenario these questions may give you. I think there is so much value in the stability framework because it expands beyond tools like the ABCs, which are really quite limiting. You are now able to rank patients based on whether or not they are experiencing the unexpected and recognizing their stability level. And experienced nurses do this subconsciously all the time. I would encourage you to start going through some NCLEX-style questions and begin applying the stability framework. I think you'll be amazed at how many more questions you start getting correct and at your progress in transitioning to thinking as a nurse.